Recently, we saw the release of Ubuntu 25.10 Questing Quokka. Yeah. That's the name we're going with. The first release shipping with the Rust rewrite of the GNU core utils. And I feel like everyone, myself included, was kind of expecting that this would be the thing where something goes wrong, where there would be some untested area, some weird combination of tools that only happens in the real world that nobody really knew was going to be a problem. And there would be some outcry, there would be some problems, and things would go really badly. Or at least, you know, bad enough that people would at least acknowledge the fact that it happened. And at least so far, there have been some reports, about 3 of them post-release. Yeah. So, hey, something happened, just not that much. And obviously, I do expect something to happen down the line, some problem to be uncovered. It's not like nothing is going to happen from a lot of people suddenly using your toolset. But it went a lot better than I think everybody expected. However, with that not going on, with nothing at all happening there, the actual problem with the release of 25.10 kind of came out of left field. A whole nother system that has nothing to do with this, that completely broke on launch. It's been fixed since then, but just didn't work. That being flatpaks, you just couldn't install them. It would just break. This was not flatpak dependent. Installing anything would cause the exact same problem to happen. You would try to do so, it would look like it's going fine, and then it would say, could not unmount revoke fs fuse file system at this path right here, could not unmount, and it just kept saying the same thing, and you also got this child process exited with code 1. After failing on every single thing you tried to install, it would say, error, failed to install the thing you tried to install while pulling from its location from remote flat hub while fetching this right here, SSL connect error. Now, being an SSL connect error, you might assume this is a problem with OpenSSL. It's not. It is a problem with another system, which is reporting as an SSL problem. So obviously, with this being broken, with users not being able to install flatpaks, that's a pretty critical error. So this problem was actually reported to Ubuntu's launchpad. However, we'll talk about when it was reported in a moment. Impact. Fuse mount 3 and U mount, which is invoked by the same confinement on the current Ubuntu questing, requires additional privileges in order to work properly. In particular, the lack of these privileges broke Flatpak because it was newly and no longer able to unmount revoke FS fuse. This is a distinct failure from a previous one reported at Launchpad. This is a problem that happened back in 24.10 Ubuntu Plucky. It looks similar, but is a separate problem. And we know it's separate because the problem doesn't actually happen on Plucky, it is only happening on Questing. And down here we have some replication conditions for testing this before it got patched. Now, take note of the date this was reported on. 2025, September 5th. This was reported on September 5th. This was reported a couple of weeks before the release of Questing. This is not a post-release bug. This is a bug that was known about and was being fixed, but didn't get fixed in time. However, this is the report on Launchpad. Worse than this is there's actually an older version of it. So this is a report from 2021 about an issue on Arch Linux. This is not exactly the issue we are seeing. However, towards the end of this, somebody actually does report the problem here. From Lewis Rubel on August 19th. I was testing this on Ubuntu Questing Quokka development branch, and following the steps for installation of Flatpak and FlatHub led to the issue for this thread. Applying this person's solution, I was now able to install Flatpaks as a user without needing to install it as root. However, after a reboot, it did not work anymore. Now, the Flatpak maintainer here was very confused because, well, this is a problem from 4 years ago on Arch Linux, so what do you mean applying those steps? That doesn't make any sense. This is not a problem for you. This hadn't actually been reported to Ubuntu yet. And then about a month ago, users who were testing an early version of Questing Quokka all started to flock here. On Ubuntu 25.10 Questing, I found the problem appeared after updating Fuse to 3.17, downgrading to Fuse 3.14 from the 25.04 repos, and holding the packages Fuse and Fuse 3 resolved the issue for me. If you have the same flatpak version and downgrading Fuse doesn't help, then there are two issues. I have the same issue, but I haven't tried the downgrade yet. Did you upgrade to 25.10, or was it a fresh install? I have this issue in GNOME software on a fresh install of Ubuntu 25.10. I installed it 2 days ago using the nightly ISO. However, as this didn't appear to be an upstream issue with Flatpak, this was closed as completed because there's nothing that they can do on the Flatpak side to fix a problem that is with Ubuntu's packaging of Flatpak, where problems could occur. The additions to the Fuse Mount 3 profile are loosened in confinement. However, if a user manually modified the installed profiles, then the package upgrade would cause conflicts, and the rejection of the incoming changes either by hand during the interactive upgrade or automatically during a batch unattended upgrade would result in end users not getting the packaged fix. Now, you might notice that this title is very generic, and this seems very well written. This report we are seeing here isn't actually the original report. The original report looks like this right here. Hi, I'm a bug tester and wanted to install a program, but then I got this error. Here is my full log. This is like a more normal report you're going to see. This is the report that was added after they worked out what the problem actually was and just wanted to make sure that it was clear in the bug description on Launchpad. Now, there is a pretty good description of what is happening over on itfoss. Flatpak depends on Fuse Mount to mount and unmount files during application installation. The tool requires access to files like /run/mount/utab and related files such as /run/mount/utab.star. AppArmor is currently blocking access to this. Without it, Fuse Mount and unmount, which it invokes, cannot complete the unmount operation, causing Flatpak installations to fail. There is a workaround for this. So over in this report here, right around here, there was a workaround for this. This was not intended for long-term use, because effectively what you're saying is just ignore the rules. We don't need to think about those. We'll deal with it later. So it kind of just circumvents the fact that you are using AppArmor. So obviously with that, they were saying, yes, you can do that. However, it's not exactly an optimal solution. It isn't something we should be doing as the long-term fix for this. But, you know, if you're a user that wants it to work today, at the time, it was a good enough way to just get it working. But at this point, we are still before release. We're still a little bit before, and there was still a bit of time to fix things, but the time was quickly running out. So eventually we get to this one right here. This is when it becomes very important to fix it. Am I right in understanding that AppArmor and Questing has started to ship a profile for Fuse Mount 3, which it didn't in Plucky, and this completely breaks Flatpak? This sounds like severely affects applications beyond the package responsible for the root cause, and importance critical is justified then. I don't know if there is time to fix this before release or not, but even if not, Ryan, please could you prepare an SRU urgently? I'll also subscribe previous sponsors of this package. This is your responsibility. Now, that profile did exist in Plucky as well, and it's strange this issue is only affecting Questing, but yes, this was a critical problem. Yes, we need to deal with this basically ASAP, because this was the day before release. Right? When it's still in beta, you know, you can fix things when you fix things, but like, once this released, then users were gonna see it, and then users were gonna complain about it, and now you got a problem. So on October 10th, one day post-release, one day after people realized, Flatpaks do not work right now, there was a proposed solution created. This was available in the Questing Proposed repo. Please help us by testing this new package, see this right here, for documentation on how to enable the proposed repo. Your feedback will aid us getting this update out for other Ubuntu users. If this package fixes the bug for you, please add a comment to this bug mentioning the version of the package tested, what testing you have performed on the package, and change the tag from verification needed questing to verification done questing. If it does not fix the bug for you, please add a comment stating that and change the tag to verification failed questing. In either case, without details of your testing, we will not be able to proceed. Some users and devs went and did some testing and it appeared it fixed the problem. Now, the problem is, usually when something like this comes out, there is some delay in releasing the fix because you want to make sure you do some internal testing on it, make sure it's not regressing anything else, make sure it's, you know, actually properly fixing the problem, and it doesn't look like it's fixing the problem, but there's actually some long-term issue with it. This is such a critical problem, though, that there was kind of a push to, you know, get more verification for it just to make sure everything is good. Also, there was the whole thing of, you know, don't push big changes, don't push fixes on a Friday or a Saturday because there's probably not going to be as many people around to deal with the problem. So they got some further verification from other users, from maintainers of various flavors of Ubuntu, and it seemed like, from all accounts, it was a good fix. It was dealing with the problem. And the only person that had an issue was the person who didn't install the update, who thought they were testing the update. So at the end of the day, is it really an Ubuntu release if something doesn't go wrong immediately upon release? Whether it be installs breaking, whether it be something like Flatpak breaking, can you really have a release of a new version of Ubuntu if everything goes smoothly? Now, the thing that went badly wasn't what I thought, and it wasn't what anyone thought. But hey, maybe the Uutils problems are still going to come. Or maybe it's actually in an amazing state and it's just good. I'm glad the Flatpak problem is resolved. So yeah, that's good. It's good that users don't have to deal with this anymore. But it's always fun to see when something breaks. So if you liked the video, go like the video. Let me know your thoughts down below. Go subscribe as well, and if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to the Berape, linked in the description down below. I forgot how my outro worked, so I'm just gonna end it.